I'm honored, thank you.
A bro scientist is someone who reads everything they can with an open mind, including research, and then does experiments to see what works best for them without being constrained by what the research proves. A bro scientist is someone who realizes that bodybuilding is not an exact science, and that there's things that work that aren't necessarily proven by science. Research is important, but you gotta use it properly. I know this sounds really stupid, but you gotta do your research before you make up your mind what fitness and nutrition program you're gonna use, not after. A lot of people make the mistake of deciding what they're gonna do fitness and nutrition-wise based on what they hear in the locker room, and then when nothing could change their mind anyway because they're so excited about their program, then they do research to justify to themselves that they're doing the right thing. Another mistake people make in using research is to rely on biased sources. There's a lot of fitness and nutrition websites out there, and a lot of them list lots of research studies that back up their claims. And if you read them, they really seem to make sense. The trouble is, it's human nature to highlight those studies that prove your point of view and to omit or discredit those that are opposing your point of view. It's not that these people are trying to deceive you, but the information and conclusions are biased nonetheless. So what's a mere mortal to do to decide what's hype and what's backed by science? You need to hire a pro, and that's not me. Subscribe to an excellent research review like AARR, where you get an unbiased analysis of the latest research that pertains to bodybuilding. There is a lot of garbage out there. Let a pro read through it and find the gems and put it into language that we can understand. Many people make the mistake of just reading the abstract of the research. That's a mistake because it can completely mislead you. Let me give you an example. There's this one fasting study, and the abstract makes it sound like the best thing since sliced bread. The trouble is, when you actually read the details of the study, you find out that, not only did they use a horribly inaccurate method of measuring body fat, but 28% of the people dropped out of the fasting study. Now, you can imagine how skewed your results would be if five people who were getting discouraged dropped out of your test. All you'd be left with is the people with good results. That is a perfect example of why you got to read the study. And I do not have time or the ability to read these studies and tease out little details like that. That's why you got to hire a pro like AARR. By the way, I have no association whatsoever with AARR. So what's the right way to use research? Well, you take this pre-digested, unbiased research summaries from a place like AARR, and then you decide what techniques and nutritional methods might work for you based on your goals and limitations. And then do some bro science experiments. Try a couple things and see what works best for you. Doing your own experiments requires two things. First, you gotta know how to measure your progress accurately. And second, you have to understand how to do experiments. You cannot be successful at bodybuilding unless you understand basic science. In my opinion, the two most important classes you can take are chemistry and physics, especially the labs, because you learn the scientific method. Another important thing to realize is that what works for one person may not work for another, which is why it's so important you do your own bro science experiments. There's also a strong link between the mental and physical. You can call it the power of positive thinking, you can call it the placebo effect, it doesn't matter, it's absolutely real. If you think that the workout program you were on is going to give you great results, it probably will. Let's look at why. If you believe your workout program is going to give you great results, what happens? Every morning you wake up excited. You cannot wait to work out. Not only that, when you get there, every single set you give 110% effort. You do that extra rep or two. And you work out a little longer. And certainly you don't skip workouts because you're too excited. Conversely, if you're not excited about your workout and you're just kind of plodding through it, doing your reps blindly, looking around, you can't possibly have good results if you don't believe you are. That's why I always tell people, you gotta experiment and see what works best for you. Bodybuilding is not an exact science. If it were, there'd be one sheet with a checklist of things you have to do to look like Arnold. There's nothing like that. The reason is, it's not only what workout and nutrition plan you're doing, but whether you believe it's the right thing or not. If I believe that 5x5 is the best workout and someone forces me to do CrossFit, I'm gonna have horrible results. A really important point. Research never proves anything. It merely suggests. And for every study you find that suggests one thing, you can find another that suggests the complete opposite. The biggest mistake people make is in cherry picking the research that agrees with them and completely ignoring everything else. What's worked best for my personal performance, health, and physique has been eating 6 meals a day, doing a 5-day split bodybuilding style workout, and doing 5 to 10 hours of cardio a week. Am I recommending that for you? No, I don't even know what your goals are. What you gotta do is do some research from unbiased sources, and based upon your goals, come up with some things that make sense to try and do some experiments. Alles klar? That's it for this week. Scooby, King of Bro Science, over and out.